Today we are here at the Zeehorn and Centrum at Peter Buren, the seal sanctuary, and you are seeing in front of me two harbor seals, which are also called as common seals. We do some experiments to understand how seals use their whiskers to track fishes here. In our lab, we take inspiration from fishes and seals to develop state-of-the-art flow sensors.
In experiments done on real seals, it has been found that a seal can track a fish that is as far away as 180 meters. Now, the whiskers of the seals are really known to be responsible for this. These seal whiskers have an undulating shape, which really helps it damp out its own vibrations. So they become really sensitive to the wake street left behind by fishes.
To explain the phenomena, if we tow a cylinder across in water, the cylinder vibrates in the direction perpendicular to the towing direction due to the vortices formed on the sides of the cylinder. But if you use a whisker-like undulatory structure and tow it, it does not vibrate at all as much as a cylinder. Therefore, a whisker cancels out the vortex street and the vibrations caused by flow structure interaction. It may apparently appear that what we work is really on understanding how animals use their sensors, but most of our work has found really cool applications in a wide range of areas. Let me take an example here. The fish-inspired flow sensors that we developed are currently under pilot tests at UMCG to understand the fluid management in the hospitals.
So we have taken inspiration from fishes and especially their lateral line organ to design these sensors. So the good thing about these fish-inspired sensors is that they are small and they are sensitive to very low flow rates. Now this can help us a lot in the biomedical industry. So what my colleague has done here is that he has designed a wireless data acquisition system. So we have integrated our fish-inspired sensors into this intravenous catheter line. And the sensor is sensing this flow rate in real time. And the overall idea is that we want to realize smart wards in the hospitals, wherein nurses and doctors will be able to see these flow rates in real time without having to go to each bed. Now, this can, of course, prevent accidents and dosage adverse drug events, but it can also, more importantly, reduce the nurse workload.
So what we do is to look at the morphology, materials, and the sensing principles of some of the sensors that are present in nature. Most of the time, they tend to be biocompatible, biodegradable, and sustainable, which are all added value to artificial sensors that we could develop.